What is convectional loop and how does it affect your house? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be talking about what convectional loop is and how it affects your home. Before we get too into that, please take a look down below. There's a thumbs up, make it blue. I appreciate you guys doing that for us. So, what is convectional loop? Maybe you've heard this somewhere, you know that it can apply to building science and heating and cooling a house, but you're not quite sure what it is. Long and short, real simple way to think about it, convectional loop is the process of heating an area and then that area or structure, in this case your home, losing that heat through a few different ways. So think about it, heating an area, how can that heat get lost out of that area? One thing you can think about is heat passing from one structure to another is when you cook. So think about you put, you know, a steak on a frying pan. First, you're gonna turn the heat on, right? You're gonna put that pan on top of the stove. That pan gets hot from the heat coming off the stove. Once that pan gets hot, you're gonna put the steak on. The steak will then absorb the heat from the pan. That's how we cook food, right? Your house will do the same thing in slightly different ways. So if we look at your home, you're paying for some type of furnace, even if it's a wood stove, something like that. You're paying to heat that space, right? So you're heating up that air. You're putting it into your house. Now, what are all the ways that your house can lose that heat? A number of different ways. One simple way, think about this. If the air inside of a room is heated, the drywall that's on the outer walls will absorb some of that heat and get heated up also, right? Well, that heat can then transfer through to the studs that are inside the wall. That can then transfer through to the sheeting that's outside of those studs. That can then transfer to the siding that's on the very outside of your house, and so on and so forth. The point is, heat that you're creating inside your house is constantly wanting to leak out through all different ways. The process I just described through the drywall all the way out to the siding, that's a very slow process. That takes a long time. If you have penetrations in your house, such as, you know, air loss around your windows, air loss through your attic, through your walls, door frames, things like that, you will lose heat much, much faster through air movement. So keep in mind, if you have those penetrations in your building envelope, you're letting that heat out at a much faster rate. Something to keep in mind. That's why we talk about building envelope so much in Foam University. That's how crucial it is. Now, keep in mind, when you create that heat, obviously that takes energy, right? That's where we pay our energy bills to run that furnace or however we heat our house to make that airspace warm, to force that hot air into our living space. So when you're thinking about convective loop, think about your house like that. Think about a balloon. And if a balloon that's full of water has a bunch of little pinholes in it, you're gonna see all those leaks. Our goal is to seal up all those pinholes as best we can. You want to seal up all those penetrations by sealing up that building envelope in every way possible. If you have more questions about this, please check out the article that's posted below. Also, drop us a comment if you'd like. Don't forget, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and ring that bell so you see all of our notifications.